Fake It Till You Make It Art School is made possible with the help of coffee. Tips are greatly appreciated and help keep the show running. Welcome back to Fake It Till You Make It Art School, a bi-weekly show on art through the lens of a learning artist. Today's topic is a peculiar one, so do get comfortable. Country humans are exactly that. Countries that have been personified and given a human body. However, what confuses me is the fact that their heads are circles and that the flags of the country they're representing is on it. Another feature is that the country humans are often based on stereotypes for each country. For example, America is depicted as being loud and obnoxious, while Finland is depicted as being cold and aloof. Where have I seen this concept before? It'll come to me eventually. Then there's the whole shipping countries thing. Like, America tends to be shipped with the Philippines, which is odd considering America's history with said country. Also, Finland is sometimes shipped with Estonia, but there are some interpretations where Estonia is Finland's sister? Something is not adding up and there's something going on here. Country humans derives from country balls, aka Poland ball, which is exactly what you think it is. Countries being personified as balls. It comes from the INT board on Krautchan, which is a German version of 4chan. However, what separates country balls and country humans is that country balls primarily pokes fun at other countries, historical events, and international affairs. What does country humans have? Shipping and animation memes. The idea of anthropomorphizing things is not new. We've done it to planets, logos for brands, and even diseases. Fandom surrounding said things is not unheard of either. This video won't be shitting on country humans as what they're doing is relatively harmless, but there are some things worth talking about. Mainly shipping. I do want to preface that I don't want to control people on who they ship which country with, but there are some ships within this fandom that raise an eyebrow. Ships like America X every country it has invaded, and most infamously, Third Reich Germany X the USSR. There has been some debate as to whether the shippings in question are offensive or not, and I think it's an interesting discussion to have. Some people have argued that it's not offensive because it's all fictional. However, I have a problem with that sentiment. Fiction doesn't exist in a vacuum, especially when said fiction is based off of real events. Pairings like Third Reich Germany and the USSR are concerning because it downplays and even trivializes horrific things done by both regimes in an era of history. It most certainly makes me uncomfortable when ships like these are accepted in the fandom. Do I think these people are being malicious when it comes to shipping these countries? No, absolutely not. Looking at most of the people involved in the fandom, it's mostly comprised of those aged between 12 to 16, so it's most likely a case of not knowing any better. I'm not gonna be making a call out post for these kids anytime soon. Let's be real here, we've all done and said stupid things when we were kids, especially when it pertained to fandoms. I used to write fan fiction involving the Nostalgia Critic when I was 15. Speaking of fan fiction, I feel there's a ton of potential for satire and offensive humor for these kinds of fanfics. Yes, even the shipping ones. Believe it or not, you can be offensive without resorting to making bigoted statements. Take a look at comedians like Bo Burnham, for example. They say offensive things, but there is a lot more being brought into the conversation. Without nuance and wit, you wind up with people like Jeff Dunham. If you know a good thing or two about world history, you could create some real interesting fan fiction, even with a dumb premise. Remember, there's no such thing as a bad idea, just bad execution. So what's my opinion surrounding this? It's just not for me. I can't get behind the idea of shipping countries, especially when said country has been involved in some horrible things. I very much rather have my Poland ball, thank you. And that wraps up this episode of Fake It Till You Make It Art School. If you like this video, check out my channel for more content. And until then, I'll see you guys next time.